What is up guys, कैसे हो आप लोग? Welcome back to another video on the 23 Rides channel. Hopefully with this video I am starting a new series. This is going to be called the Lessons Learned series. Now what are the lessons I have learned that I want to share with you? I have decided to kind of start learning some basic off-roading skills. All of us want to buy these big heavy adventure touring motorcycles because they look cool, you feel powerful while riding these machines, but frankly speaking I think 9 of 10 riders who have these machines lack the skills, basic skills that are needed. Now I'm not talking about doing Ladakh, Zanskar, Spiti, I mean I have done that a lot of times, but still I feel that one needs to have those basic skills to ride such motorcycles in a much more confident manner. In this video I'll be talking about the 180 degree spin turn. Some people call it the elephant turn, but this is the turn where you spin a big heavy adventure motorcycle 180 degrees using the fine play between clutch, throttle and the inclination that you give to the bike. Now this sounds easy, I've seen a lot of videos on YouTube. I want to share with you my experience of how I learned this. So what you will get in this video are those finer details from a standpoint of a novice, small things that will help you execute this smart looking maneuver. What do you need to do a spin turn? Now I have been practicing this maneuver alone, so I need to be 100% careful about the safety here, both of myself and the bike. Now first thing that you would need is adequate crash protection on your motorcycle. Now like you see in the background, you have the Tiger 900, an expensive motorcycle. I have adequate protection on the motorcycle. I have the bark busters, I have the proper upper fairing crash guard, I have the lower engine crash guard, I have the sump guard, although not required here, but the bark buster and the crash protection upper and lower is absolutely necessary if you don't want to break your motorcycle. While trying this, the bike has fallen about 6 to 7 times in the last 5 days, so you need good crash protection. Second, what you need is you should be practicing all this stuff while wearing the riding gear. I am wearing riding pants, I am wearing proper riding shoes, I have my helmet here on the bike there, so riding gear is required in case you tend to lose control of the bike and the bike falls on your legs. Riding gear will save you, and in case you give extra throttle and the bike runs into the bushes, then the crash protection will save the bike. Apart from that, what sort of surface do you think you should practice it on? I am practicing in a relatively low traction environment. As you see here, this is kind of a dusty surface. This is where losing traction is going to be a little easy. Find a quiet place where there are not too many people around you to judge you, because you don't want to be conscious, because the bike is definitely going to fall and you are going to look like a fool, who's trying to do weird things out in the middle of nowhere. So a quiet, silent place, isolated, where you can concentrate on the technique that we'll be talking about. And the last thing that you need to be prepared for before trying such maneuvers is you should know how to pick your motorcycle. 225 kg machine. If you don't know how to pick it, you will be left stranded in the middle of nowhere and nobody's gonna come and help you. So you better learn this skill first before trying all this fancy stuff. Ow. Okay, put the stand where it belongs, and yeah, once you are comfortable with this, then only try this. So now let's talk about the basic technique in terms of executing this 180 degree spin turn. Let's gear up and show you how it's done. So if you are having a proper adventure motorcycle, how do you prepare the bike to execute the spin turn? The first thing that you will need to do is put your bike in the off-road pro mode that is available on the Tiger, or a similar mode which allows you to switch off the traction control and ABS. Once that is done, of course put the bike in first gear. And of course I assume that you will have some sort of a sense of balance of such a big motorcycle, and let it rest just between the hip area and the knee area, this small contact patch. This is how I am balancing the motorcycle. This is something that you need to be a little comfortable with, otherwise you will always tend to feel the weight of the motorcycle, which will tire you out. You can't fight a 220 odd kg motorcycle with this full tank. So it's all about optimizing the effort, reducing the amount of effort that you need to execute a maneuver. Now, once you are comfortable with this, because right now I can stay in this position like this for maybe like 5-10 minutes easily, I'll just get bored, I'll not get tired. So you know what I mean, this is what you need to establish, getting this balance right. Now what you need to do after this is, you need to tilt the handlebar to the extreme left. I have locked it on the extreme left, but now the bike is exerting a little more force on me because it's wanting to fall over on the left. See this motion, it's wanting to fall over on the left. Once we have it in the first gear, try to lean the motorcycle as much as possible. Now, leaning the motorcycle, like I told you, we want to get the bike on the sidewall. How much do we lean it? That is one point that I got really stuck in. And since I was not leaning the motorcycle enough in the initial few attempts that I was making in the first 2-3 days, I was not able to break traction on the motorcycle. So how much do you lean? I think one of the best indicators that I found out was that you lean the motorcycle to an extent. I'm getting this foot out, I lean the motorcycle, and I lean it to the extent that my left arm becomes straight. Now, some people might call this as the lean, some people might call this as the lean, but this is not enough. You have to go till this level where my left elbow is completely straight. Getting it back should be easy for you. You have to establish this sort of balance first. Once this is done, then the magic happens with the clutch and the throttle. You have to control the clutch with two or one fingers. That is very important. I mean, this is basic off-roading stuff. Having one finger on the clutch, for me, ensured that I could dump it in the right manner. You will hear this term again and again, dumping the clutch and revving at the same time. That will result in magic, be it this 180-degree spin turn or those wheelies and all. But dumping the clutch, if I have to tell you in simple terms, you have to just, if you're holding the clutch like this, you have to just let it go. Just leave it. It will go out completely. That is what you need to do. Revs is something that you need to keep at a minimal. You have to rev the motorcycle, but not like, you know, you are revving it at 4000 RPM or 5000 RPM. That is absolutely not required. When you see these videos of these pro riders doing these 180-degree spin turns, you see that mud flying around. That kind of gives you that feeling that he is throttling it out big time, and hence the motorcycle is powering through, and hence it's doing that 180-degree spin turn. But trust me, just dumping the clutch and keeping the revs say around 2,500 or 3,000 RPM, that is going to do the trick for you. You better be a little lower on the revs and dump the clutch properly than not dumping the clutch properly and being higher on the revs. Now, a disclaimer here, if you try to give a lot of revs to the motorcycle and you are not dumping the clutch properly, that could be disastrous because the bike will tend to stand up, get to the vertical position and go into the bushes. The trick here is playing with the clutch with the one finger, dumping it properly. To start off, allow the bike to stall when it's trying to turn. That is where you will understand the complete friction zone of the clutch. Ideally, you should have that knowledge before trying this maneuver. Letting the bike stall is a much safer option than letting the bike go into the bushes. I hope you agree with that. So that's how we'll execute this. Let me show you finally how this is done. Starting the bike, bending the handle towards the extreme left, locking it. Now comes the fun part where we lean the motorcycle and the arm is straight. One finger should be on the brake, by the way, so that you can control if things go haywire. The foot should be pointing approximately in the direction where you want to go. So as you can see, my left foot is pointing somewhere there. Of course, I need to do a 180, but we'll adjust the foot as the bike starts losing traction. And finally, the most important thing, because where you look is where you go, so you look in the direction where you want to go. Oh, you saw that? We started from there and we came here. This was more than 180 degrees. We'll give it one more try, but one more tip that I would like to share with you, which I've learned from the experience over the last few days, is when you have the bike leaned over. Now, You have this left foot peg here. Your right leg should be behind this, because if you place it ahead of it, if you kind of get into this sort of a situation where the foot peg is behind the right calf, then when the bike loses traction and moves forward, this foot peg will directly go into your calf and might hurt you, and also will, you know, hinder the whole spin motion that happens. So keep this right leg behind the foot peg. Oh, perfect, perfect. That was a full 180, like you saw, and this is how you do it. Now, if you also want to learn this, of course, you can follow the instruction that I've given. There is loads of instruction anywhere, everywhere on the internet. But what is most important is that you need to get out and spend some time alone practicing this. Of course, this can't be done on those Sunday rides, the breakfast rides where you have coffee, parathas and everything. You need to take out time and try this stuff. That is it for this video. I hope you enjoyed the insights that I shared, and also had a fun time seeing someone try this who is not a trainer, who is not a pro off-road rider. I'm just like you guys, bought a big adventure touring motorcycle, have done lots of trips, but these are the skills that I now really want to learn. I will see you in the next video, guys. Bye bye.